People, whenever you analyze data, you must have a coding structure, right? This is the coding tree. This is the coding structure. So when I have a lot of research already existing on the topic, then I am moving from the variables. I can already deductively code my data. So the question that you're asking, Linda, where you say, but what if there's not enough literature or research, then what you are going to do is what we call the grounded approach. One of the things that you have to disclose or understand early on is your research logic. What is the relationship between your work and existing theory? What do you do when there isn't much research or literature on your topic? This is a very good one. So when it comes to how we approach things, this is where we get to the question of research logics, right? So earlier I said one of the things that you have to disclose or understand early on is your research logic. What is the relationship between your work and existing theory, right? So if you are investigating a topic where the theories are well established, but maybe you want to test certain elements of it, you are going to say, I'm testing theory, right? And that is going to affect things. So let me show you just as an example. This is a coding tree. This is from a paper that I wrote together with a wonderful friend and collaborator, right? And I say to people, whenever you analyze data, you must have a coding structure, right? This is the coding tree. This is the coding structure. And what you do with a coding tree is that usually you are going to have your raw data, right? This raw data tells you certain things. It's codes that people make, and you can actually define them in some way. And then you will usually reduce them and say, okay, this feeds into second order concepts, and then ultimately the constructs of interest that I'm going to be exploring, right? So what makes the difference, Lindo, between when I don't have much research and when I have a lot of research? When I have a lot of research that already exists on a particular topic, then the general direction of my analysis is from the theory going into the data, right? So it means that I'm going to do a literature review, and this literature review is going to reveal to me what the important variables or constructs are, right? And then based on these variables or constructs, I might actually find certain elements that are related to it, whether they're concepts or whatever, right? And here we call them second order. And then we are going to have our first order codes or quotes. In this paper, we used codes because we were using secondary data. And if we will take direct quotes from the data, it was going to be too chunky, right? So when I have a lot of research already existing on the topic, then I am moving from the variables. I can already deductively code my data. So I say, here are the pre-identified variables or constructs that I'm interested in. These variables or constructs are linked to these concepts in the second order. And now I'm going to analyze my data and look for the information that allows me to populate these different things. So the coding logic, when there is already a lot of research existing on the topic, is generally from the variables or constructs, and then going towards the data. This is it. So the question that you're asking, Linda, where you say, but what if there's not enough literature or research? Then what you are going to do is what we call the grounded approach. In the grounded approach, your data leads the process, essentially, right? So in the grounded approach, now I don't know how to spell approach, forgive me. Okay, so with the grounded approach, probably a double P, but it doesn't matter. You will understand. In the grounded approach, you have the opposite. With the grounded approach, you are going to go and you're going to collect data, right? And you are going to ask more bigger grand tour questions because you're not sure what you're looking for. So you have some initial questions, and then as people answer those questions, it becomes clearer to you what could be important and what you look for, and then you interrogate them a bit more. And then actually your analysis logic is going to be going from these first order codes and then progressing towards the variables or constructs. So the grounded approach usually means that you are building theory, right? Or at least, well, sufficiently new theory. It's not always going to be 100% new. So this is what you do. If you don't have enough literature, then you are going to rely a lot on the data, and you use this data through a grounded approach. So you build your theories from the ground up. You use the insights from the data and you work backwards towards identifying the second order codes and then ultimately the relevant variables or constructs. That's what you do when you don't have enough literature. So it means that you have to have a really good understanding of what sort of question am I asking, right? And how does that allow me to collect the data that's going to help me to build my theory from the ground up, to use the data to inform the theory? Whereas with the other types of research, when you already have enough theory or you have enough explanations, then you're working backwards. You are starting with a pre-populated list of variables or constructs, and maybe you might even identify the concepts to some extent, and then you just find those insights in the existing data. That's all. And then if you don't have enough, then it's a grounded approach. You start from the data, you use this data to build the second order concepts, leading to insights on the variables or constructs that actually matter.